we need to create the second one. That one's really easy. We're just going to Command C to copy, and let's Shift Command V, which will paste in place. In other words, it's pasting the copy directly over the original. Click and hold Shift and just move that into place over the second map pin. The only thing is that I need to sample the color of the second map pin because it's a slightly different green. So I'm going to just temporarily move that out of the way, go back to the eyedropper tool, hover over this image, click, and then let's go ahead and move that back into place. All right, so now I've got two map pins. All right, now for the third, let's Command C, Shift Command V, click, hold Shift, and drag over the third pin. Let's make the stroke black and the fill none so that we can see our image beneath it. And let's go ahead and change the width of the stroke. So this stroke is 4 points, at least on mine. Now it just depends if you resize these, if you resize this image when you placed it and it's not at 100%, you might need to use a heavier stroke or a skinnier stroke, but at 100%, 4 points is about right. Only problem is when we add a stroke to our path, it centers the stroke on either side of our path, so it makes our circle, or it makes our pin a bit wider than it really should be. So let's go to the stroke window. Let's drag that out. And let's go to Stroke Options, and let's choose Align Stroke to Inside. Okay, now it's not going to align exactly because, again, our image below is not perfectly symmetrical, but that's okay. We want it ultimately not to match the original image so much as match the previous map pins that we created. So another thing we're going to do is we're going to round the corner. So let's click that, round join. And that just rounds this little corner right here. So let's expand the stroke. Go to the object menu, choose expand appearance. And what that does is it creates a closed path with a fill inside. So notice how the stroke switched from black to none and the fill switched from none to black. So now rather than having a black stroke with a weight of 4, we have a stroke of none and a fill of black. Let's recreate the check mark. Before we start, let's change our fill to none and our stroke to black. Choose the pen tool. Hold the Shift key, click and drag at a 45-degree angle, click again, drag at a 45-degree angle, click again, and then hit the Escape key. Let's add a weight to our stroke. 6 points should work. Let's use the rounded cap and the rounded corner. Now, if you applied the rounded cap to your stroke and it goes too far beyond the template, then you can make an adjustment. Go to the direct selection tool, click on the anchor point, click again, hold the Shift key, and then you can drag to the point that you'd like. If you need to make your stroke shorter or longer. All right, so try to match up as closely as possible the image below it. So let's expand our check mark so that we have a closed path. Go to Object, Expand, hit OK, and notice that the stroke is now none and the fill is black. Let's apply our green color to this check mark and map pin. It's the same green color as the first matte pen, so let's just sample that color. Now we need to change the interior of our matte pen to white. So make sure that you're selected on the matte pen object. Command C to copy, Shift Command V to paste in place. Right click to choose Release Compound Path. Select the outer path and choose Delete. Now with the inner path selected, let's change the fill to white. And now let's go ahead and right click and choose Arrange Send to Back. So now we have our check mark, our white interior, and our green border. Select all of those. You could drag a selection over all these objects to select them all at the same time. Right click and choose group. All right, so now what we want to do is move our drawings off of our original template image. So just click and drag down or up, doesn't matter, so that they're sitting right next to each other. So we want to see our original image, and then we want to see our vector art recreations. And the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to space these out a little bit, just slightly. Okay, so once you're finished, you're going to want to make sure you save this as your last name underscore VCD1430_03micro, and then you're going to save it as an EPS. So choose Format EPS, choose Save. I've already saved one in here, so save. Okay, and so you'll have a folder. Inside the folder will be your EPS file and your original PNG image. You're going to submit the zip file. So you're going to right-click on the folder, choose Compress, and the zip file is the one that you're going to upload to the assignment link.